Hello, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. We are all welcome once again to our Arabic grammar lessons with النحو الواضح. I think by this time we should all يعني say a gratitude message, or we should all say a thank you to the authors of النحو الواضح. يعني they've done so great that they've made grammar very simple. They've simplified it. Nahu doesn't stop here. Better steps from here, you could move to Ajrumiya, any of the explanations on Ajrumiya, and then from there you can go to Qatar, Nada, Alfiya, and so on. But if you do an-Nahu al-Wadi and you pay attention and you revise very well, you are very okay to a higher extent if you do it very well. Okay. Now today we are looking at another topic, al-Alam. Now you make sure not to just complete the book. That is one thing that I fear so much for students. You don't hasten to finish a book. What you do is that you try to, the little part you could do of any book, try to do it very well and understand it very well. Now, Nahwu is supposed to what? Correct errors that we make when we speak, grammatical errors. Now, what is the essence if you've learned Alfiya, Qatranada, Kitab Sibawai, and at the end of the day, you speak and you make a lot of grammatical mistakes. You've achieved nothing. You've done a course 90 week. Grammar is supposed to straighten our tongues. When we say a word, we should end with the right vowel. So when you learn any topic, its effect is in Arab. You should know, make sure that, oh, they said the fa'il ends with dhamma, maf'ulun bihi ends with fatha, or maf'ul fa'il ends with raf'u. It's marfu, maf'ulun bihi is mansub. Okay, and now that comes after harfu jar is called ism majrur, and it ends in, it becomes majrur. Yani basically it ends in kasra. You should have all this running at any moment in your conscious memory, so that when you are speaking, you don't err easily. For errors, it comes, but then if the errors becomes like a usual thing, then your grammar has no essence. Okay, so in grammar, it's not about piling a lot. It's about understanding the concept very well and putting it into application. Let's get to our topic today, inshallah. We are looking at al-alam. Now, when you hear al-alam, what should come in your mind is alama. Alama, a sign. And if I say this thing is a sign of rain, then that thing, that particular thing points to that there is rain. Oh, this thing is a sign of love, let's say. This thing is a sign of love, then that means the thing points to love. If I say this thing is a sign of good news, it means that particular thing, whenever it happens, there is good news. That is alama. Alama. Now, when we say al-alam, it's quite the same thing. Almost the same thing. When we say al-alam, it is a noun. But proper noun, what we say in English as proper noun. And now that refers to something specific, not a vague noun. And now that when it is mentioned, you know, oh, we mean this. When we say Redwan, you mean Redwan. When you say Ghana, you mean this country, Ghana. Say Nigeria, you mean Nigeria. Wilayat al-Muttahida, United States. Names that when you mention, it falls on something specific. The name has been put as a sign for that thing. Yani the name has been made as an alama to this particular thing. Then the name is called al-alam, yani proper noun. Okay. Al-amthila, examples. You say Aliyun fil hadiqa. Aliyun, Ali. The person Ali is in the garden. Aliyun fil hadiqa. Ali is in the garden. So we have Ali here. It says Jarat Aisha. Jarat Aisha, yani Aisha ran. Jarat Aisha. Aisha ran. So you see Aisha there. Tajri as-sufunu bayna Misra wa Uruba. As-sufunu. Ships, the plural of safina. As we've seen a lot of topics speaking about it. We've seen the safina to Sahara, if I'm not mistaken, or we are yet to see it. The camel. We've seen Safina, definitely. We've done something about the Constantinople and all this. Safina is a ship. Tajri bimana runs. It says, tabgin najata walam tasluk tariqataha. you seek success and you don't take its part. Inna safinata, verily the ship, la tajri ala al-yabasi, the ship does not run on bare land. It's a wise saying in one bait like that. Tabgi an-najata wa lam tasluq tariqataha. Inna tabgi an-najata wa lam tasluq tariqataha. Inna safinata la tajri ala al-yabasi. You seek to get success and you don't take its part. Of course, the ship does not take the bare land. It runs on water. So tajri sufunu, the ships move baina misra wa uruba, between Egypt and Europe. Baina misra wa uruba, the ships move between Egypt and Europe. Now you are speaking Arabic, you know how to say Europe. You don't say Europe, say uruba. That is the Arabic one of it. Say uruba. Okay. Tashtahiru uswanu bijawdati al-hawai. Tashtahiru uswanu, I think there is a dot here, but it's not showing clearly. Tashtahiru uswanu. Uswan is the name of a place in Misra. Now we have Misr here, we have Uruba here. Uswan is the name of a place in Egypt. Uswan, one of the beautiful places in Egypt. Bijawdati al-hawai. When you say jawdati shay, you need a quality. Jawda is quality. So sometimes you see a video on YouTube and then you see added to it bijawdatin aliya, with high quality. Bijawdatin aliya, with high quality. This Uswan tashtahiru is become famous. Uswan is becoming famous or has become famous or is famous for quality of air. Bijawdatil hawa, for quality of air. Yani the air in Uswan, the city of Uswan, is very cool, is very quality. There is no pollution in it. Okay. London, our own London, akbaru biladil ingliz. London is the biggest country, the biggest English country, biladil ingliz, the biggest English country. London is the biggest English country or the biggest English city. Yani the word bilad goes for everything, but London, of course, London is the biggest English country. Okay, it says safara abi ila dimyat. My father traveled to Dimyat. Safara abi ila Dimyat. My father traveled to Dimyat. Is also a place in Egypt. And I think the name is Dimyata. Dimyata. Okay. My father traveled to Dimyat. Okay, so now you've seen the nouns. When they are mentioned, Ali is the name of somebody, proper noun. Aisha is a proper noun, refers to somebody specific. Misr is the name of the country, Egypt. Uruba, Europe. Uswan, we have it there. London, we have Dimyat. These are names of specific places, specific people. Okay, now Al-Bahth, he says, Nanzuru fil amthilati fanara أن الأسماء. He said, we look in the examples and we see that the nouns Ali, Aisha, Misr, Uruba, Uswan, London, Dimyat, you find that these nouns يدل على يدل كل منها على شخص أو مكان معين. Each of them refers to a person or a specific place. It refers to a specific person or a specific place. يدل على شخص معين أو مكان معين. معروف لنا. That is known to us. فهذه الأسماء إذن معارف. Then these nouns are all معارف. The plural of معرفة. You remember we just did النكرة والمعرفة. And I told you the topics, they connect with each other. They are all dependent on each other. None of them is independent. فهذه الأسماء إذن معارف. Then all these names, they are definite nouns. All of them are definite nouns in the first place. He says, وإذا بحثنا في سبب كونها معارف. If we should look at the reason that makes it definite, سبب كونها معارف. We look at the reason that makes it definite. رأينا أن الذي سمى كل شخص أو كل مكان أراد أن الاسم يدل عليه بعينه. ويكون علامة له. He says that if you should check for the reason, رأينا أن الذي سمى كل شخص. We realize that the one who named الذي سمى, the one who named كل شخص, each person, أو كل مكان, or each place, the one who gave them these names, أراد أن الاسم, the person wanted that the noun يدل عليه بعينه, should point to it specifically. يدل عليه بعينه, it should point to it itself. So the one who named me Redwan wanted that when the noun Redwan is mentioned in my house or in my place, wherever I am, when it is mentioned, I should turn. It is my sign. So the one الذي سمى كل شخص أو كل مكان أراد أن الاسم يدل عليه بعينه. He wanted that the name should refer to the person or the place specifically or itself. ويكون علامة له, and it should be a sign for it. So when you are walking and you see written there a map, an arrow, it is called suwa. Suad, wow, I think Alif Maksura. That signpost that you see, the names of places to guide you. You find it in Izzat al-Nash'in, I think in around the first chapter. That pole that there is some tags on it to direct you. You find it written on it, Dimyat or Cairo or Al-Qahira. You find written Al-Jami'ah. Yani, these are signs. It should guide you to what you intend to, where you intend to go to. So those who named people places, they intend that when the name is mentioned, it should be a sign for that leads to the person. فَإِنْدَمَا سَمَّاكَ أَبُوكَ. And so when your father named you, قَصَدَ أَنْ يَكُونَ إِسْمَكَ, قَصَدَ أَنْ يَكُونَ إِسْمُكَ خَاصًا بِكَ. He intended that your name should be specific for you. خَاصًا بِكَ, should be yours. إِذَا نُطِقَ بِهِ, if it is pronounced, أَيُّ إِنْسَانٍ فَهِمًا السَّامِعِ أنك المقصود به دون غيرك, دون غيرك. إذا نطق به أي إنسان, إذا نطق به أي إنسان. If any person mentions your name or the name of that particular place, or if the person mentions your name, the name your father gave you, or the nickname you've given yourself, فهم السامع, the listener understands, أنك المقصود, that you are the one who is intended. You are the intended, the person that is this particular mention is aimed at. And أنك المقصود, you are the aim. أنك المقصود به دون غيرك, that you are the one that this name that is mentioned is intended for, and not anyone apart from me. So if I'm at a place and somebody calls out Redwan, of course, right away, I will turn. I know that it is me they are calling, not anyone else. So if I should turn and see somebody else being called one, I'm like, hey, of course, it will call my attention because that's my sign. Aywa. وَإِذَا كَانَ لَكَ كِتٌ, if you have a cat, وَسَمَّيْتَهُ إِسْمًا, and you give it a name, فَإِنَّ هَذَا الْإِسْمَ, then this name يَدُلُّ عَلَيْهِ وَبِعَيْنِهِ. This name refers to it and it's itself. It refers to the cat itself. وَهَذَا النَّوْءُ, here I think this is a yai, though وَبِعَيْنِهِ is not a problem. يَدُلُ عَلَيْهِ بِعَيْنِهِ, not a problem. But because of the wow, you say, وَإِذَا كَانَ لَكَ كِتٌ, if you have a cat, وَسَمَّيْتَهُ إِسْمًا, and you give it a name, فَإِنَّ هَذَا الْإِسْمَ, then this name يَدُلُّ عَلَيْهِ وَيُعَيِّنُهُ, this name refers to it and it sets it aside. وَهَذَا النَّوْءُ مِنَ الْمَعَارِفِ, and this part of definite nouns يُسَمَّى عَلَمًا, is called عَلَم. This kind of definite nouns is called عَلَم. We have other nouns that are definite but are not specific. Like if I say الرَّجُلُ, الرَّجُلُ refers to who? The man. Though it is definite, but it's not alam. It doesn't refer to somebody specific. So this can be a highlight for you. Now, al-qa'ida, the ruling. You see, I just said al-qa'ida, al-qa'ida. You see, if I pronounce the ayn with hamza, it makes it look like the leader. Al-qa'id is the leader masculine, al-qa'ida to the leader feminine. It sounds like the leader. So al-qa'id, al-qa'ida, the ruling, the grammatical ruling. It is just like this word al-alam. If I say al-alam, I read it with hamza, alam, it means pain, P-A-I-N. You know, so Arabic is a language of sounds. Let's be careful. Al-alamu ismun ma'rufatun. Afwan, al-alamu ismun ma'rifatun. Alam is a name that is definite. It's a definite noun. Summiya bihi shakhsun. That is used to name a person. Aw makanun, or a place. Aw hayawanun, or an animal. Aw ayyu shay'in akhar, or anything else. So if a name is given to something, and the name is specific to that particular thing, when the name is mentioned, you can pick it out of many. Then that name is called al-alam. Please do well to be memorizing the qawa'id. It is very important. At this point, we do not need any i'rab. At this point, we do not need any i'rab. We know the i'rab of safara. We know the i'rab of abi being the fa'il, ila being harf jar, dimiyat being ism majrur. We know all this i'rab. When we get to where there is a need for any new i'rab, inshallah, we will attend to it. Okay. If you have any questions at all, do not hesitate. Do well to put your questions forth. You find something that goes against a grammatical ruling I have taught here. You find something that goes against anything at all I have taught you. Of course, I'm not a professor in Arabic language, so I can also fall in an error. Also, you might have found something you didn't hear what we said here very well, so it makes you confused. Please do well to ask, inshallah, and we always do our best to attend to it for you. And do well to share for others to also benefit. Till we meet again, إلى لقاء آخر أستودعكم الله والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.